History of classification of living organisms. Millions of living things inhabit our planet, but do we really know that how living things were actually classified and on what basis? In order to study so many species, biologists have classified them based on the characteristics they share. There have been many classifications of living organisms throughout the history. Each classification has its own significance and understanding about living organisms at that particular era. To understand it in a better way, let's explore the history of classification of living organisms. So, what are we waiting for? Let's get started. The initial classification was given by Aristotle around 350 BC. He is also known as the father of biology and father of zoology. He classified all known living organisms into two groups, that is, plants and animals. He used simple morphological characters to classify them. He classified plants on the basis of their habitat, that is, into herbs, shrubs and trees, whereas classified animals into two groups, that is, anima and enema, on the basis of the color of their blood. Theophrastus, around 370 BC, classified plants into herbs, shrubs, undershrubs, and trees. He is also known as father of botany and father of ancient taxonomy. Aristotle's pupil, Theophrastus, also made several other important botanical distinctions and observations. Theophrastus deserves a special mention when considering botanical science. Two-kingdom system of classification. Carl Linnaeus proposed two-kingdom system of classification. He classified all organisms into two kingdoms, that is, kingdom plantae and kingdom animalia. Carl Linnaeus is also known as the father of taxonomy. Not only this, but he also made great contributions in the fields like binomial nomenclature for naming plants and animals, taxonomy, taxonomic categories, and much more. But as more organisms were identified, they realized that it was not always possible to make this distinction, as they did not fully share characteristics common to those kingdoms. Not being able to differentiate between unicellular and multicellular, photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic was a major drawback of this classification. To solve this problem, Ernest Haeckel, a German biologist and philosopher, created a third kingdom called Protista, where he located all unicellular organisms. This classification is also known as three-kingdom system of classification. In the course of time, scientists learned more about diversity of microorganisms. They discovered that there are differences in the cell wall of organisms. Herbert Copeland proposed a new kingdom Monera, in which he placed bacteria, since they are all prokaryotes. This is also known as four-kingdom system of classification. Before we take a system of classification, bacteria and fungi were placed in kingdom plantae. As more and more characteristics of fungi and other microorganisms became known, more advanced classification became the need of time. Kingdom fungi was given by R. H. Whittaker in 1969 on the basis of mode of nutrition. He proposed five-kingdom system of classification by considering the criteria like cell type, body organization, mode of nutrition, type of reproduction, and phylogenetic relationships. Carl Woese proposes the modification of the Monera kingdom by finding that bacteria have different types of metabolism. He proposes dividing them into two large groups, which he named bacteria and archaea. He transformed the Monera kingdom into two domains, that is, bacteria and archaea. Since archaea and bacteria have not been subdivided, both domains and kingdoms can be considered. This was proposed by Woese in 1977 when he was noting differences between archaea and bacteria present at the level of ribosomal genetics. He kept rest of the kingdoms together in one domain, that is, domain Eukarya. This system of classification is also known as three-domain system of classification or six-kingdom classification. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If so, hit the bell icon and make sure you subscribe to my channel. And do watch my other videos. Bye guys. See you next time.